Hello guys, welcome to the lab session of Microsoft SQL Server Database. So the topics that we are going to cover today is SQL backup and restore, SQL log shipping, SQL export and import, SQL stretch database, and migrate the data to Azure database table, and configure stretch database. So let's start. So just to refresh your memory, I hope you all remember the backup type supported in SQL 2016. It's a full backup, differential backup, and transactional log backup. All right. So what is the restore mode in SQL? Okay, it's a simple restore mode, full mode, and bulk locked mode. Alright guys, now let's review the three backup types. So in full backup, as you can see in this slide, you took the full backup at 12 a.m. and then every 2 hours you took transactional log backup. Let's assume that SQL Server crashes at 10 p.m. So what you have to do, remember? Yes, you have to restore the full backup and then all the transactional log backup. So it's very time consuming because you first you have to restore full and then 8 transactional log file backup. So I hope you remember the RTO and RPO. So in this case, the RTO is very high. So all right guys, now move to our next backup, which is differential. So in differential backup, you took full backup at 12 a.m. and then each 2 hours transactional log backup. So we also took differential backup at every 6 hours. So now let's assume server crashes at 10 p.m. So how many backups you have to restore? Right. First full backup and then last differential backup at 6 p.m. and 2 transactional log backup created after 6 p.m. So in this way, we are able to reduce the RTO. All right, guys. Now let's review the recovery mode. So let's understand the simple recovery model. As you can see in this slide, we have 3 backups, one full at 9 a.m., differential at 10 a.m., and another full backup at 11 a.m. Assume that there was a hardware failure at 10:45 a.m. So if the database was using the simple recovery model, you would have lost 105 minutes of work. So the last latest point at which you can recover the database is 9 a.m. Since that was the time the last full backup was made, you could schedule differential backups to run periodically. The differential backup contains only the changed data pages. It cannot be used to restore to a specific point in time. You will have to restore the database to it to its 9 a.m. state and redo 49 minutes of work. All right, guys. Now see our next recovery model, which is full recovery model. So here is an example. So in this example, we assume that the transaction log is backed up every 30 minutes after full backup at 9 a.m. So if a hardware failure occurs at 10:45 a.m., you would lose 15 minutes of work. Anyway, it's better than losing 105 minutes of work, right? So you can use the full database backup at 9 a.m., apply the transactional log to bring the database to its state at 10:30 a.m., right? So what if some critical database was deleted at 9:50 a.m.? Using the transactional log backup that was made at 10 a.m., you can restore database to its state at 9:49 a.m. immediately that, admittedly, that would be great, right? All right, guys, now move to bulk log recovery model. So here is the situation. The situation with the bulk log recovery model is identical to the full recovery model if no minimal log transactional are created in the database. An example of minimally log transactional transaction is a selected into operations. Say that such a transaction occurred at 9:48. So this transaction would be minimally logged, which means that SQL Server only record the changed database pages arising from the transaction. It does not log every insert into the new table. Again, say that critical table was deleted at 9:50 a.m. What happened now? You can no longer restore the database to its state at 9:49 a.m. as the transaction log backup created at 10 a.m. cannot be used to restore to a specific point in time. The best you can do is to restore the database to its state at 9:30 a.m. Whenever a transaction log backup contains one or more minimal logged transaction, you cannot use that backup to perform point in time restore. All right, guys. Now let's move to the next part, which is log shipping, and then we play the recorded lab session that we had. So what is log shipping? So what is log shipping, guys? Log shipping is the process to automate the backup of transaction log files on a primary database server or the production database server and then restoring them onto a standby server. All right guys now move to the recorded session of our lab, where we first installed another instance of SQL Server and then we took backup of one of the database and then restored it into a secondary instance. So remember, guys, it's a recorded session, so there would not be any voice instruction. Okay, so let's start.